Welcome to the launch of Manjeet Hirani's first book, How to Be Human, Life Lessons from Buddy Hirani. Okay, so I personally am really thrilled to be here because first of all, I'm a big admirer of Manjeet, who is a commander and a trainer at Air India. Okay, this is a woman who flies Boeings, right, Manjeet? And so I don't even call her Manjeet, I just address her as commander out of respect. And I'm a big, big dog lover, so this is the perfect place for me. So without further ado, I want to call on stage Rajkumar Hirani, who's actually responsible for introducing Buddy to Manjeet.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, a big thank you for being here on a Monday afternoon. Thank you, Amir. Thank you, Anu. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Manjeet, as Anu said, is an airline pilot. She flies, and now she's written a book. And I have no hand in it. I have no idea. I had no idea that she was writing a book. One day she came and she said, you know what, Penguin is publishing my book. I said, when did you write a book? She said, yeah, I just written a book. I said, where? I never saw you writing. She said, I used to write in the flight. So that's the first day I understood the meaning of autopilot. So, as Anu said, my only contribution to the book is the dog, which inspired her to write. That's Buddy. Veer, my son, he always wanted to have a dog. And the reason we didn't have a dog was because Manjeet was really scared of dogs. She used to refuse to go to house, anybody's house for a dinner or lunch if there was a house there, if there was a dog there. Yeah. Dia's house, she would refuse to go because there used to be a dog there. And she jumped on sofas with a little simple bark. Actually, very affectionate bark will make her jump onto sofas. So there was nowhere a dog could come into a house. Till finally, we were shooting PK with Amir. And if you remember, there's a scene in PK where Anushka is a news editor and she's holding this dog called Niku. And she says, it was a little spoof, where she says, kaha jata hai ki janwar kabhi suicide nahi karte. Ye Niku hai, Ramesh Nagar ke Sweetie Singh ka kutta. Sweetie Singh also here somewhere. magar is kutte ne aaj 3 suicide attempt kiye. Balcony se chhalang lagai, gas burner pe kood gaya, sleeping pill chaat liye. So something like that, we had a scene. And so I had told my team to look for a dog who looks very depressed. Somebody who looks very depressed wants to die. So they got many pictures, and the one I liked was a 2-month-old pup, a Cocker Spaniel. Just because they have these long ears, you know. And they look very innocent and very cute, and you feel like they're really troubled and you want to help them. So this pup came on the shoot and all of us fell in love with the dog. So finally, end of the shoot, I told the animal supplier, can I take this dog? I want to take it home. So I put it in a little basket, put ribbons around it, with a little note, sent it for Veer home, with a little note saying, you know, this guy is going to be your best friend ever. Just handle your mom. And Manjeet even refused to touch it. She was like, touch it and run away like that. But that was 4 years back. And now, is the same pet who is with her all the time, licking her all the time, staying with her, she's taking her for walks. And the best part is, the same pet has inspired her to write the philosophical book where she's compared how actually we learn about humanity from animals. So, I guess over to Manjeet.
I wanted to bring Buddy over here, but everybody refused. They said, Buddy can't come here. So I've got this depiction. Look at me. So,
on stage? No, come on, Manjeet, say something. I mean, how does a commander just begin writing a book?
As Raju said, the dog came to our house, and I love philosophy. For me, everything is philosophy, whether it's my food, my diet, or my life, So I used to write blogs on it. And when Buddy came, I used to... That's dumb. As they said, with Buddy, I started because we promised that, you know, he'll do everything for him. But after some time, I realized we're only plays with him. That's it. So I had to take charge of his food, his immunizations. So one day I thought I'll take him for a walk. And I took him for a walk close to my house. And when I went out, after some time, there were many, many dogs who started chasing us, all the stray dogs on the road. And I really got very scared. Actually, I started crying. There were some nearby people. I said, please, you know, just surround around me and shoo away the other dogs. So when I came home, I discussed with somebody. And they said, don't go to that area. You go near the Oberoi International School. Over there are no dogs. That was near my house. So next day, I went over there. Till the time I was, till a point, there were no dogs. But when I crossed the street, again, a lot of dogs started chasing us. So again, I crossed the road. Then I came home and I realized that, you know, dogs are very territorial. They have their own territories. But then I said, arey yaar, ye toh, when you read about animals and wildlife and all, even apes are very territorial, the tigers are very territorial. I said, why only then? Even we humans are very territorial. We also have our own territories about religion, about countries. We are fighting over Kaveri River. Those days, this big hangama going on about Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. I said, Pani the nature ka hai. Why are we fighting over it? So that fascinated me a lot. And I wrote my first blog. That's called Territory. It's still on my site. Then Buddy started growing up and he hit puberty. So again, I said, even my son was 14 years old that time. I said, Buddy ki puberty hai or iski bhi puberty hai? But I said, Buddy ki puberty, we are accepting it very nicely and we laugh about it. But when it comes to our children, we put so many restrictions on them. We are like watchguards. So then I started writing blogs on everything I observed. So when I had written 10 of them, I was hovering at Delhi airport and I met one salesman at W.H. Smith bookshop. And I told him very confidently, okay, I've written a book on my dog. Can you give me some names of publishers? And he gave me 3. So out of them, I called up Penguin. Radhika is here, my editor. And I spoke to her. So I told her, I've written a book on my dog. So she's saying, can you give me 50,000 words? So I told her, see, I don't understand words. I've written 10 chapters. She's saying, okay, then can you give... Then I sent her a link on WhatsApp. And next day, she's saying, do one thing, I like the concept, give me 20 chapters. Then I wrote the rest in and gave it. And then she edited my book and today it's written. How did it start?
Okay, with that, let's get on stage our chief guest of the afternoon, Mr. Aamir Khan.
Hello everyone, really happy to be here on this wonderful day and most excited that Manjeet has written a book. Even I am very keen to read it, as I am sure you all are. So wishing you all the best, Manjeet.
So Aamir, what's your relationship with dogs? I know you have one.
Well, I have always loved dogs and growing up, I spent half my time at Nasir Saab's house. So there were always dogs over there and... there was these 2 Alsatians and 1 golden retriever when I was really small. And that's when I really got attached to dogs. For very long, I tried to, get a pet. But my mom was dead against it. But somehow I managed. And then since then, I've always had a dog or a cat or both. So right now we have Emily, which is a dog and... we have a cat called, my God, what's her name here? Miri.
Good save.
Yeah. Miri is our cat and Emily is our dog. And I'm very bad with names, so please excuse me. Sometimes forget my own. So, before this I had 2 dogs, Choti and Peanuts. So I've always really loved dogs and I think they're really wonderful.
So, Aamir, you think we can learn from pets?
Well, actually, it had not occurred to me until Manjeet called me up and Manjeet wrote to me about this book and she, when I you know, read the title of the book and you told me a little bit about it, then I realized that actually you're very right. Until then, I had not thought of it. It's so true that actually we can learn so much from not only our own pets, but from animals around us. Yeah, because they're really less judgmental than we are. We are very judgmental as people, and we're judgmental on many, many, on many things, you know, for many reasons, which you don't really need to be. Whereas an animal is also judgmental, but on a very few things. It's judgmental about his survival. तो अगर कोई डियर जा रहा है तो वो जजमेंटल होगा शेर की तरफ कि यार ये मुझे खा जाएगा तो दे आर जजमेंटल ऑन सर्वाइवल वेयर इज वी आर जजमेंटल ऑन सो मेनी लेवल्स यू नो ऑल द टाइम
यू नो इन वन ऑफ द चैप्टर्स इन द बुक मंजी टॉक्स अबाउट डिस्क्रिमिनेशन यू नो वन वर्जन ऑफ बीइंग जजमेंटल एंड शी सेज बडी डजंट डिस्क्रिमिनेट His only thing is that he loved people who love him. So it's a very easy sort of straightforward thing. And you use that, Manjeet, to sort of extrapolate to the way we all discriminate against each other and are judgmental, like you said. You, Manjeet, became an airline pilot in 1989. I can't imagine there were many women pilots at the time. I mean, the discrimination and the judgment must have been really at another level. How did you get beyond that?
Actually, I'll give a little background about myself. I came from a very, very traditional family. To an extent, both my brothers are here. We were like, when I was born, I was engaged. It was so traditional that it was decided, you know, that extent.
Raju?
No, Raju was not the guy.
बचपन से तुम लोग की शादी तय थी? अच्छा
मेरे साथ ही
मतलब यू एंटर्ड एंड यू हीरो की एंट्री मार
सो माय फादर डाइड वेरी यंग आई वाज ओनली 13 इयर्स ओल्ड एंड ही डाइड ऑन 29 दिसंबर ऑन 25 दिसंबर जस्ट 4 डेज बिफोर ही गॉट मी ऑफिशियली एंगेज्ड लाइक अ प्रॉपर रिंग सेरेमनी एंड एवरीथिंग सो आई हैड नो एंबिशन आई हैड नो गोल ऑल आई न्यू वाज आई हैड टू गेट मैरिड आफ्टर 2-3 इयर्स और समथिंग दैट सीन व्हेन यू शो इन दंगल आई रियली
दंगल या
Believe me, I cried on that scene a lot because I could so much connect to that scene.
Right.
So when I came in college, for me it was ki, you know, I can't curb my freedom.
Mm.
And something, the voice was there ki, the guy came to meet me for the first time in college. And when he came, the only thing I told him, I can't marry you. And I don't want to marry you. That's it. And when I came home, my brothers, my family, they all supported me. And we broke the engagement. Though it was a very close relation, but we had to take the flak of our relatives and everybody. So as I said, there was no ambition for me. The only thing I knew, I had to be a graduate because in our family, girls would study till 10th or 12th max. SNDT college, mein, home science course. Kar liya. But utna hi limit tha. So for me, I wanted to be a graduate, which I became. Then after graduation, I worked and then I became an air hostess. Even that, my relatives didn't like it because they said a lot of things. They took us, my mother, to some hostel in Matunga and they said several things. But my mother's logic was, isko mil gaya. Let her go and see it, you know, what it is. You can always quit the job. But when I became a hostess, after 6-8 months, I realized ki, I have to move on, you know, I have to do something more. So, unto ek serial aata tha, Udaan. You know, there was a story about an IPS officer, Kavita Chaudhary.
Yeah, Shikhar was also there, na, in that. Shikhar Kapoor. Yeah, Udaan, I remember that. Yeah.
So, you know, I was very fascinated because it was a struggle for her to be in the men's world.
Right.
She was the only lady officer. तो मुझे लगता था ऐसा कुछ स्ट्रगल करना चाहिए यू शुड बी इन द मैन्स वर्ल्ड
दैट दैट सीरियल इंस्पायर्ड यू
वेरी मच सो मच दैट आई रियली वांटेड टू एप दैट लेडी ओवर देयर
दैट
आई वांट टू बी इन मैन्स वर्ल्ड एंड डू समथिंग लाइक वर्क फॉर इट सो देन आई थॉट ऑफ बिकमिंग अ पायलट ऑल्सो एन ओवरनाइट डिसीजन बिकॉज इट इंस्पायर्ड मी बिकॉज देयर वाज अ लेडी पायलट इन अ एयरलाइन कैप्टन सौदामिनी देशमुख So I said, and that is the first time I realized you can fly as a woman.
Mm-hmm.
I always thought I'll marry a pilot, but that didn't work out, you know. So anyways, then I went for my flight.
Raju, you're such a disappointment on so many levels.
No, but Raju is a pilot. He has his own flight.
Captain of the ship.
Absolutely.
And there I go. I became a pilot, but I have to thank my brothers and my family because they actually fought, and my mother took a lot of flak from my relatives for doing all this to me. Mm.
So hats off to your family. Yeah.
For supporting you, yeah,
yeah,
wonderful.
That's amazing.
Wonderful.
Amir, I don't know if you know, but you have a special appearance in the book.
So I have a special appearance in the book?
Yeah, because apparently Buddy is like you. Huh? He's extremely disciplined.
Okay.
He eats only 60 grams of dog food a day. You know? But you measure your food in...
He weighs his food.
She, yeah.
You wait for her.
You,
for
yeah, her. She like...
Acha?
He doesn't eat anymore. So since we can't ask Buddy, I'm asking you, how can you achieve that level of discipline?
Actually, I am not disciplined at all.
Really?
No, you must know this about me. I am totally indisciplined. The only thing that gets me to be disciplined is my work. So if I was not an actor and not in this field, then I would have been the most indisciplined person. So the only reason I'm disciplined is because my work requires to me to be. But actually, otherwise, I'm not very disciplined. I know it's hard. Everyone's looking at me, kya baat kar raha hai? But this is a fact. I'm very, you know, indisciplined. And I mean, the people who are close to me know that. They know how indisciplined I am. It's the only thing that work that pulls me, you know, back to track and makes me do what I have to do. Yeah.
I've been to your doctor, same dietitian, Dr.
Dr. Dhurandhar, yeah.
And he gave me food like 30 grams of rice,
portions,
70
huh?
grams of atta,
yeah.
70
yeah.
grams of chicken.
Huh.
I did it for a few days.
Then you gave up.
Gave it up.
You decided you won't do it, but you make Buddy do it.
Yeah.
You know, there's one chapter, Manjeet, where you talk about death. And you talk about how human beings are the only people, I mean, the only creatures who are aware of death. And therefore, we are sort of obsessed with, you know, being afraid of it and kind of obsessing with the idea that we're mortal. Whereas Buddy has no clue that he's going to die. And therefore, he completely lives in the now, which is, of course, an amazing concept. But I want to ask the two of you, how do you actually do it? Because to begin with, it would mean putting our phones off, right?
Well, actually, I rarely think beyond the present. Very rarely
do. You do it? You actually live in the now?
I live in the now. And I never have long-term plans. It's always what I want to do right now. And I've realized that when I'm, no matter what I'm doing, what I'm doing right now, my entire focus is on that one thing. Whether it's eating, whether it's meeting somebody, whether it's, you know, watching a film, whether I'm in discussion with someone or, you know, shooting or working, whatever I'm doing at that time, I'm fully into that and nothing else distracts me from it. So for me, it comes naturally. I don't start thinking, ki, acha, kal kya hoga, parso kya hoga. I don't think of the future.
And you don't multitask. It's that one thing.
Sometimes I do when it is really necessary and sometimes, you know, it's you have to multitask, but I don't enjoy that. So by and large, I don't multitask.
What about you, Manjeet? Are you able to live in the now?
Actually, I won't say all the time because if I meet Raju, he tells me something, then I think of the past, but this is what you did 6 months back or 8 months back or something. So.
Raju, this is not going well for you.
But one thing what I've learned from Buddy, this really one thing I've learned, I would say the major take from Buddy is, you know, when there are guests in the house and Buddy always wants to be there. He's always there at the doorbell to receive the guests. And some people don't like dogs. They detest. It's understandable, you know, they're scared of them. So we ask Buddy to leave. But when you ask him to leave, he just doesn't want to budge. He'll sit, believe me, like a stone. You can't even lift him that way. And if you try to do something, he'll get very ferocious that time. So then we get some chicken sticks and give him a treat or something and we send him back. So when the guests have gone, all, everything is over, then we call him back. Then he comes back. He comes back with the same energy, as if kuch hua hi nahi. You know, he's forgotten that I can't imagine doing that. I'll show attitude if somebody does that.
Yeah.
We all do that, you know.
Yeah. But look, grudge, he doesn't keep any grudge at all.
Not at all.
Though you've pushed him out of the house.
And we were mean to him.
Haan.
Char log lage hain uske saath ki usko stick de rahe hain.
वो
डिसअपॉइंटमेंट के साथ जाता है कभी खुशी के साथ
और जब आता है तो लेकिन भूल जाता है
सब कुछ भूल चुका है ही कम्स द सेम एनर्जी इज हगिंग यू कुछ हुआ ही नहीं So I'm trying to change myself, and that's one big takeaway.
But that's really wonderful. Yeah. I'm dying to read the book, yeah, because I think it will have many such things which will
inform us. So that I feel is power of now.
Yeah.
Because now the moment is correct. Jo hua tha, ho chuka hai. But when you're meeting the person the next time, you have to forget everything and enjoy that moment.
Manjit, you also talk about how Buddy actually loves Veer more than he loves you, because Veer is more affectionate, he sleeps in Veer's bedroom. Did you, while you were writing it, sort of think about how honest you can be and how much you should not say?
No, it's an honest book actually. This book is totally transparent as it is. And that I'm a person as it is, you know. जो मेरे दिल में होता है मैं बोल देती हूँ. I don't edit. मुझे हाँ राजू का काम है.
देश और विदेश की हर तरह की न्यूज को हिंदी में सबसे पहले देखने के लिए हमारे चैनल लोकमत न्यूज हिंदी को सब्सक्राइब करना ना भूलें.